हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस मीटअप एंड आई रियली अप्रिशिएट योर एंथुजियाज्म अबाउट कमिंग एंड लर्निंग न्यू थिंग्स इवन इवन सच सिचुएशंस लाइक लॉकडाउन. माय नेम इज़ आनंद प्रकाश तांदळे एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू गिव एंड ओवरव्यू अबाउट इफेक्टिव एंड एफिशिएंट यूज ऑफ पाइथेस्ट फ्रेमवर्क. So let's start. So first of all, first question which will come in your mind is basically what is framework? So framework is like a software or a program where things or components are used, managed and abstracted in a such a way that it will help to fulfill the requirement in a unique way. So in early days, if you remember, we had ball pens and refills. So only specific ball pens in only particular ball pens we can put specific refills. So one of my intelligent friend who actually found out some patent in artificial intelligence and machine learning, he told me a framework is something if you know all in all inside of that framework, you will get to know how exactly you can efficiently use that framework. So why framework get famous is basically its uniqueness, its easiness. If you understand the communication between different components of that particular framework, and if the framework is fulfilling the unique use cases in its different way, in its different unique way, then definitely a framework will get famous. So today we are talking about PyTest framework. So what is a PyTest? So it's basically a framework for checking Python code written is working fine or not. So it's basically testing whatever you written in Python are working fine or not. We can test any functionality like databases, functionality of APIs, functionality of UI as well. So we can test different functionalities using PyTest. So why PyTest? So it's basically free and open source. We, if you know about free and open source, we can say it's a very powerful tool. Any open source tools are powerful tool because we can tilt it in our way because it's open source. PyTest has simple syntax. It can also help us to execute multiple cases, multiple scenarios in parallel manner, so that we can test the scenarios in very efficient manner. And even we can take easy decisions about the executions, what exactly we need to execute. So that decision will be in our hand if you use PyTest. And of course, time efficiency, as I mentioned. So if you go about PyTest and if you want to learn about PyTest, first you need to understand what are the prerequisites of PyTest. So first of all, you need to familiar you have to be familiar with Python. Python must be installed, of course, and then you should have PyTest module installed. And PyTest have different modules, so if you want to use that model, you need to install it. So for that, you need to have the knowledge of PEEP. So, and how you can install is basically PEEP install PyTest. PEEP is nothing but a package management system used to install and manage packages written in Python. Like many packages can be found in different source of packages and their dependency in Python packages indexes, which is PyPI. And PEEP is a basically acronym of that. So if you install PyTest, PEEP using PEEP install PyTest, then you can check whether if you are able to successfully install or not using PyTest-h command. So it will give you all the subcommands for the PyTest. Before going to the execution, so one of the important thing here is assert. So many people who are using PyTest are using assert in their code. See, it's a very basic But if you don't know, I can tell you that assertion are it's simply Boolean expressions that's basically checks if the conditions return true or not. If the condition returns true, then program doesn't do anything and move to the next line. However, if it returns false, then definitely program stops and give or throws an error. So that's what assert is work. So many of the PyTest user at the start of their like career in Python or PyTest, it's basically they are using assert. So let's go to the execution. So if you see my screen basically, then I can tell you that whether PyTest is installed or not. It's basically my system is Fedora. So if you check which PyTest, my PyTest is add user bin PyTest, PyTest -h, you can see lot of help. Forget about this warning at the start. It's basically a package is there are new packages available and I am having older packages. So there are lot of subcommands and lot of options you can actually go through explore using PyTest, and you can check the version using PyTest -- version. So this is my version. So let me go through since basic, because considering wide range of audience here, so we will start with the basic. So here I have written some code, so, and I will execute it and you will get to know how exactly PyTest work and how to execute PyTest, how to test your code using PyTest. So I have written a very basic code of like arithmetic operations. I am basically writing, I have imported math. I am checking a test equality. I am taking checking test SQRT square root. I am checking the square. And if you see, basically I am using assert here, assert 10 equal to 11, assert mat dot sqrt and assert. It's basically checking condition is returning true or false, as I explained in earlier slide. So we have program now, how to run it. So let's say PyTest we already have, then arithmetic.py, and we can check whether it will work or not. So great, it's working, but now you cannot see a verbose log. What exactly happening over there? You can see there is one failure and there is one green dot. So what exactly happened here? Which test is failing, which test is passed? So to know this, you can just add -happen bb. So you will get to know that test square function is failed and test sqrt function is passed. And what is a failure here in test square is basically we are checking 7 into 7 is 40, but it's not 40, and we are getting like it's a fail. So that is a basic execution of PyTest. Now let's say I have this code, but in that code I have to execute only a function which actually I want to execute. I don't want to execute all the functions. So PyTest provide a functionality of that. So basically we have three functions: test less, test greater, test greater equal. Forget about these comments as of now, we will explain. So here PyTest provide one functionality like PyTest -k, and using that we can run. So here you can see only a substring, only a function which has executed having the substring of less. So if you check, only the function is less, having the substring less is taste less. If I put a substring here greater, it should provide me two functions, result of two functions, because we have greater here as well and greater here as well. Okay, so here you can see two tests are running having the substring greater. So hyphen k is an option if you want to run particular tests, particular functions having particular substring, then definitely you can use the option hyphen k. Then we can move to next, next option provided by PyTest is basically marker. Marker is a something that you can mark, you can label this particular function you need to execute using PyTest. So I have written one another code, which is a very basic code as well, which is PyTest more examples. So you can check, there are like, I have imported PyTest, I have imported math, and this is the way you can actually mark your code, mark your function. So PyTest.mark.square, mark.others, mark.equal. So now I am going to execute. PyTest hyphen m marker, my marker, let's say square, I have square, and name of the code and verbosity. So here you can see that two tests having where we actually put the marker, they actually run. Forget about these warnings because I am having a older package. So you can check and explore as well about these warnings, but don't need to worry about that warning. So basically whatever the functions we have marked as a square, so you can check here as the square and here the square. So those two functions will actually got executed. So next functionality provided by PyTest is basically fixers. Fixers, so it's like a fixing a particular function which actually get executed every time. So even if you are running any test and different functions, if you put fixer in one particular in front of one particular definition or a function, it will get executed all the time. So let me go through you the example of PyTest fixer. So here you can check, I have put fixers, I have imported PyTest because it's required, and PyTest.fixer, and it's an input value, and I am executing the functions, like let's say I will execute like mod, I will execute like divisible, but how exactly those functions will get the value, input value, it's from here, and using PyTest it will get it because we have put the fixers. So even if I run this function or I run this function, then it will give the value, input value, and because we put PyTest fixer here. So let's run it. So PyTest hyphen k mod PyTest fixers. So here they are getting the input value. Let's go through the different example. I put here 09 and let's run the function again. So here you can see input value is 109. So even the function is passing or failing, it's basically getting the input value fixes are something like you are fixing, you are telling explicitly to the test, to the code, that this particular function I need to get executed every time before running any other function. Okay, so let's go to another functionality provided by PyTest. Is basically parameterized. If you are running something, some function having the parameters, and at the time of execution, if you need to provide parameters, how exactly you can write? Let's see, parameters. More examples. So here you can check that I have written the parameters. PyTest, PyTest.mark parameterize. And this is how I provided PyTest. It's basically like a getting the parameters and running and checking the test multiples, whether they are multiples. Assert 5 into number is equal to output or not. So first parameter is for number and second is output. And similarly, here in test equal, I am just checking 8 plus number equal to the is greater than 10. So let's execute that. Okay, so PyTest hyphen k test multi test any substring PyTest more examples dot py and vv. So here you can check test actually executing. Test is able to get the parameters which actually we are not providing inside the function, but we are providing here. We are providing like using parameterized functionality. PyTest mark parameterize, and we are providing the parameters. Now let's execute this function. So here you can see the function is getting executed. First test is failed because we have provided wrong input. Over here, just to check, assert 8 plus 2 is greater, 10 is greater than 10. No, so it's giving assertion. So that is where we can provide the parameter. So let's go in a scenario. Let's think about the scenario. If you have a code and code having a lot of test functions, and the functions, there are some functions which are not relevant, you don't need to execute in every time. So that time we can use PyTest mark exfails or PyTest mark skip. So I think in compare.py I have written this, so I will uncomment this PyTest mark exfail. So let's check what exactly happens here. Yes, first function is failed because of the input. Second, it's saying x pass because we've put x fails. So purpose of x fail is basically that it will get executed, but it won't say in such a manner like it will get pass or fail in green or red, but it will execute. But if you want to completely like skip the function, then we can use skip option. So difference between skip and exfail is basically exfail will get executed, but it won't provide result in green or red. Even if you want to generate some result, it won't provide. So I am commenting mark exfail and I am uncommenting skip. So let's check. So here you can check it's skipped. So here they are not giving any result like it's passing or fail, but at the time of x fail, they are providing result but prefixing x. So that's the difference between x fails and skip. There are some tests and there are a lot of functions and you need to run functions, all the functions, but you need to provide, if you want to provide, like if out of 10 functions, one or two functions fails, rest of the functions, I don't need to execute. So what I need to do is, basically, I need to use --max fail option. I have already executed, so I will execute it. What exactly it will check? It will check the first function is failing or any failure, for any one failure I will get, I won't execute rest of the function. So right now test less is getting failed. So let's check in compare.py. So you can check test less is failing and rest of the thing is basically not executing. Okay, so next functionality provided by PyTest is basically a very good functionality, which is a parallel execution. By default, it's running the thing, running the test sequentially, but if you want to use if you want to run multiple tests parallelly, then they provide option like -n. So it's like basically a PyTest -n, how many let's say how many in different threads you want to run, and program name. So it will execute in three different parallel manner, but use of parallelism will only helpful for us if the data and functional coverage is much larger. And if we need lot of time to execute those functions, then that time, in that case, it will work. Else, if functions are small, data is small, so it won't actually, we are not able to see much difference at that time. Okay. What exactly we need to check now? Now we are checking how exactly we can generate a report. So this is the command actually using which we can run the PyTest and --JUnit XML and result 1.xml. So we are getting the result in XML format. JUnit XML is one of the favorite module in lot of frameworks different people are using, and it helps us to generate XML. PyTest also provides us, and we can able to execute it. So you can check right now that results has been generated. Okay, we can check. So in XML format we are getting which are failing, which are passing, what are the rest of the metadata, what are the timestamp. So if someone want to grab the data or manipulate the data of XML, this is the finest way, that generating data first in XML format, and we can do operation using this particular file. So this is how we can actually generate XML using --JUnit XML. Okay, so we also have some useful PyTest plugins which actually people are not using. So one of the plugin is PyTest Random, which actually used to randomly run the test. There are a lot of tests, lot of functions, lot of scenarios which you need to test, but some coverage is not there. So if you want to execute a few tests randomly testing the functionality of the functions, then PyTest Random will help. How it will help, I will show you. So here in PyTest more examples.py, we have a lot of codes, a lot of functions, and what exactly the command is doing, running the function test randomly. So here you can see test equal run at the second time, and if I run the command again, so it will again randomly run the test, and that time we don't we will check that for test equal will test at second time or not. So you can check right now, it's checking, it's testing randomly basically. Okay, second one of the useful PyTest plugin is coverage, PyTest COV. So what exactly we can check here is coverage. If you run particular thing, where the control is going, in which code, in which line, how much it covered, how much percentage. So that command is coverage run hyphen m pytest compare.py. We are checking the coverage of compare.py. So it will take some time. It's executing. So yes, it's executed. Now I need to get actually coverage reports. How exactly I can get is using this command coverage report hyphen m. So here you can check the output, the report, what exactly this is. You will get to know many data scientists or like many people who are actually working in artificial intelligence or machine learning, or even who has written a long code, a legacy code since last 5-10 years, they need to require what exactly coverage is, so they can use that coverage. So here you can check where the control is going, how many statements are there, how many statements missing, what is the coverage percentage, what is the missing line by line. So you can check this report. So that is one of the finest functionality provides by PyTest. Coverage we have check, we have check, skip, exfil. Let's go to slide. So there are other PyTest plugins as well which are very famous nowadays. Which are like PyTest Django and PyTest BDD. So using those, there are if you want to test some UI functionality in lot of different manner, and in some particular cases we have to check using Django, then PyTest Django is a plugin. So many of the you are not aware about Django, so I'm not demoing Django, and we also have PyTest BDD, behavioral driven development PyTest plugin. So we have next session of BDD over here, maybe then definitely next time we can check about PyTest BDD. So basically it's PyTest provider of a framework wise functionality which will actually helpful to check different scenarios in Django working fine or not, or different scenarios in BDD is working fine or not. So our next section is basically how we can integrate PyTest with DevOps tools. Nowadays everyone is using DevOps tools. Since last 2-3 years we are moving to cloud, etc., containerization, Kubernetes, Docker, etc., etc. So these are the modules which we can actually use to integrate with different DevOps tools and check and test the scenarios of different DevOps, different cloud. Okay, so PyTest Ansible is a plugin which actually check the scenarios in Ansible. So Ansible is basically a configuration and management tool we can use to configure and manage different cloud, different containers, etc., etc. So a lot of functionality by Ansible. Ansible playbook is basically like we are written a code in a playbook. Playbook is basically a code of Ansible, and we can run we can do lot of functionality for Ansible using a single playbook, a single code at high level. So PyTest Ansible playbook is also a plugin which we can use to check the functionality and scenarios mentioned in playbook using this particular PyTest Ansible playbook. PyTest Terraform. Terraform is widely using a tool. It's a DevOps tool mainly used for infrastructure management, provision, etc. For AWS, Azure, or anything, any cloud, or anything you want to like manage the infrastructure, any infrastructure you want to manage, then Terraform is a tool which people are using, and PyTest Terraform we can using which we can check the functionality, test the code of Terraform. Similarly, for PyTest, we have PyTest AWS, we have PyTest Azure pipelines, depending on different clouds we have, and we also have PyTest Docker. So using PyTest Docker, we can check the functionality of Docker exactly executing. So these are basically high-level PyTest plugins which we can use. Maybe in future, if I will get a chance, then definitely I can show the demo and I can talk about these particular useful plugins which can be integrate with DevOps tools. So now we have limit of time, so we are moving ahead. So what is the summary exactly we have seen in this session till now? I am just repeating so that you will actually get like remember, or we will you can go home and check whether it's working or not. So we check installation of PyTest, we are checking how test file we are able to identify, how to write test functions, how to test functions, how to test all the functions using PyTest, what is a -v option, then using file name, how to run particular file name, particular code, then definitely substring option using -k, marker option using -m option. Then definitely about the, we have showed a demo about PyTest fixers, then how to access multiple fixers. This is one of the functionality. We also checked parameterize, how to provide parameter, how to provide parameters to the code. Then exfailing, skipping, and maximum max fail, how to stop the execution, how to run the test parallelly, and then generating reports. So that is how we have checked the in this session. So congratulations, you have learned many things in PyTest. Now we are talking about extend the boundaries of PyTest. So till now, many people are using a PyTest only for like testing few functionalities. So only QA engineers, testers are using. But if you check how I need to talk about extend boundary is basically like, so if you check PyTest -h, so you can check there are a lot of commands, like subcommands, more than 200. Lot of options are providing by PyTest. So you can explore it and you can check it. People are testing only small functions using PyTest, but we can check multiple functions, classes, we can check UI functionality, we can check databases, we can check APIs, we can check microservices, we can check cloud. As I told, we can there are modules related to cloud, containers, etc., etc., configuration management tools, infrastructure management tools. So even if you are developer, even if you are QA engineer, even if you are DevOps, even if you are doing cloud formation, even if you are maintenance engineer, there are a lot of scenarios you need to check on daily basis that this particular is scenario is working or not. And definitely there are a lot of modules provided by PyTest and you can definitely use it. Nowadays, the people who are working in artificial and machine learning in robotics field, they have to just change a particular few things and they need to check it again because they are like experimenting things. So that time as well, they are using PyTest to just check code for code is working or not. And also PyTest have, we can like integrate with Jenkins as well for continuous integration, continuous delivery. So there are a lot of use cases where we can actually use the PyTest. And definitely it's like a thinking, like it's your maturity, it's your way, it's your thought process where exactly you can check PyTest is working, and it will help all the software engineers to make their life very easy. So as I mentioned, even for developer, QA engineer, DevOps, cloud formation engineer, maintenance engineer, etc., etc. So I guess, yes, that's pretty much from my side. What is the next slide? Next slide is thank you. Thank you everyone for listening it. I actually want you to share the knowledge with your friends, colleagues, etc. So sharing knowledge also helps us to improve our knowledge. So this is my email ID. Whatever the questions you have, you can directly write me through that email. And this is my blog, anandprakashtande.wordpress.com, which will actually helpful blog. I have written some solutions for different problem I had faced, or any new software engineer student or new software engineer will face, will definitely helpful for this. So you can write down to my you can ask questions to me using that WordPress and email. Okay, so thank you everyone, thank you organizers who actually give me chance to share my knowledge. Thank you everyone. Thank you. Let's
Vishal, my screen is visible, right?
Yes, Bhavin, it is.
Okay. Yeah, Anand, this was really great talk. I mean, I have never explored these basics of PyTest. I just used to run PyTest and that test used to be already written, or I just used to add new tests to it. But yeah, this was great. We had a few questions. So Abhijit was asking if we can pass on hyphen k. We pass hyphen k, right? Can we pass regular expressions to it? Maybe
Anand,
we shall.
Anand,
yeah,
I
Vishal
guess
or
you
Anand,
are
both can on
mute. I guess. Could you please answer that? I'm not sure about that query. Maybe we can move on to second. I guess Nikhil had given an answer to that question.
Yeah, but
so
yeah.
What
I
was that?
So what he said is hyphen k try to match the content in your test IDs. So I'm not sure what is a test ID. Do you know, Vishal?
No, I'm not sure about that.
Okay. Yeah, so what he's saying, it tries to match the IDs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And he says ID consists of your test name and parameterized params. Okay. So basically, it needs to match against the name.
Okay.
Next we had, Chandan was asking how we can debug failing tests. So let's say we can use direct PDB inside test, or how that can be done. I guess that should be enough, right? I mean, you add PDB there and you just jump into the
right, the exact location,
execution path. Yeah. Okay. Maybe in the meantime, Anand can check what is happening with his microphone.
I guess other questions were answered in the chat. So I had one question to Anand. So Anand, Is there any reporting tool which can be easily integrated with PyTest?
So I guess you can use the coverage. So this is Devendra, by the way. The coverage output that you can use actually generates reports. It can generate HTML reports, or there are many visualization tools that you can use to visualize the coverage output, basically.
Okay,
Yeah, right.
so I was aware about this Allure reporting, but I was just wondering that is there any other GUI tool which can be used for reporting?
Yeah, basically the coverage output is kind of universal. That's what I understood.
Okay.
And you can use different tools to visualize that.
Right. Okay.
Okay. So there was one question. When we use PyTest instead of unit test, as the unit test comes inbuilt with Python and handles a lot of boilerplate code, which PyTest does not do. Okay. Yeah, so Nikhil answered that in chat. So what he is saying is unit tests provide us option related to testing and better to use it for unit testing or component level testing. But PyTest as a overall gives you more functionality to do more stuff.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So that's what distinguishes both of them. And
Yeah.
I usually
Also,
use
yeah.
this unit test for my unit test code or my CI test. I never use PyTest. By the way, it has great compatibility with Selenium. So if you're doing GUI test and all, then PyTest is a great way to go ahead.
Interesting. Yeah. Also, they had a good discussion in chat. If someone is watching this live stream later, they can just quickly open the chat and see what they had discussed. But yeah, Anand is also giving responses to the questions, so that is cool. Chandan also said that you can to debug test, you can just simply import PyTest and then do PyTest.setTest. So that is something new. Cool. That's all we had, I guess. Anything you want to add, Vishal, from your experience or anything?
I haven't used PyTest extensively,
That
but the
means.
features like fixtures and all, which is an added advantage to PyTest, I might want to use this framework in my later test.
Interesting.